turn the lights down. Turn them way down.
The End, obviously, is a song that that works through a great deal of dramatic peaks and valleys, if you will. It starts off very softly, and it's basically a love song at the beginning. This is the end. It's a goodbye song. It's Jim singing goodbye to a girl.
This is the end, beautiful friend. This is the end, my only friend, the end.
Then the music begins to build and build in intensity, and there becomes a whirling dervish part. The tempo of the song increases. Now this is the dramatic structure again of a film, increasing in structure, increasing in editing, increasing in intensity with which the Doors are playing.
Genesis of the stage, rock stage, as a dramatic event. Before that, you had your stage lights, a follow spot, people got up there, performed their material, sometimes waved their arms a little bit, but there was no drama. The Doors brought drama.
In the 60s, at the time, it was an interesting sort of theatrical style. It had come out of the theater of the absurd, which was a very funny, humorous, theatrical movement in the 50s, and had turned into a kind of a confrontational theater. And Morrison picked up a great deal of his way of confronting the audience from Julian Beck and the Living Theater.
If one can make the spectator really feel some pain objectively in a public ceremony, it may open the door to further feeling. That may be the route through which we can again find our feelings.
Morrison took Julian Beck's message to heart and created his persona of the threatening Lizard King, prepared to do anything to provoke an audience out of what he saw as its apathy.
To the point where Jim realized that he had an enormous power, not just the power to move people emotionally, but to move them politically. And not so much in the politic of the time. That's not what he was interested in. He was more interested in the politic of the insane.
All right for you, baby.
He started playing with that on stage to see, what can I do to this audience? Can I whip it to hysteria? Can I whip it to insanity? Can I activate the madness of crowds to my ends? And he got pretty good at it.
You're all a bunch of idiots!
Interestingly, that Jim had gone to six performances in a row of Julian Beck's Living Theater in Los Angeles about a week or two before the Miami concert took place. And they had taken their clothes off on stage, I'm not allowed to walk naked, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, all kinds of things. Jim was going to do the same thing in Miami.
Come up here and love my ass, come on. Yeah, I love you.
As president of the Greater Miami Crime Commission, I'm calling upon the Dade County Grand Jury and the State Attorney's Office to immediately take criminal action against those that were responsible for the deplorable condition and situation when the group known as the Doors attempted to precipitate a riot.
We have taken out two warrants for Jim Morrison. One of them is for indecent exposure,
In the trial, there are 250 photographs entered, a stack of photographs this high at the trial. Photos of everything, everything that was going on at the concert. Not one photo of the ivory shaft appeared. So I doubt if it happened, but I think it was a mass hallucination. I think it was something like the Vision of Lourdes or something like that is what happened in Miami. Yeah.
The Miami concert would mark the effective end of the Doors' career as a live band. Morrison had started to live out his rock god persona, dangerously close to the edge. He died mysteriously in a hotel in Paris in 1971. Another performer would emerge from the Midwest near Detroit to assume Jim Morrison's mantle and wear the leather trousers. He too would challenge the audience in an extreme and physical way.
It was another year for me and you, another year with nothing to do.
I think what was cool about where I grew up was that there was so much wild space around that I used to spend most of my time, my free time every day, I would go out in the corn and make up games. I grew up in a mobile home, actually a series of them. The one when I was little was in a mobile home court of about 100 trailers. And I think the solitude and time, the Midwestern, where I was, gave me an ability to concentrate and to imagine that would make me able to do the job later when it came up. I dropped out of college and went to try to play the blues because I liked this kind of music. And it didn't take me long to figure out that, you know, I wasn't middle-aged, I wasn't black, and I wasn't from Mississippi. But how about if I could take those ideas but do that from the point of view of our life back in Michigan?
Here's Duke Rucaway for our message. Iggy has been in the crowd and out again three different times. They seem to be enjoying it, and so does he.
Feel all right. Feel all right.
We seem to have lost him, and we're trying to get a light on him now.
The Doors were very key for us. I would listen a lot to what he was doing, and the Velvet Underground, who were very, very, very avant and very key for us at the time. But still, it was mainly about clang bang, clang clang clang, bang bang bang, loud loud and loud and annoying, and the more annoying it was, the better. And then the added element was to find something monolithic, simple, metallic, just like a big machine. And the way I got into that was because you'd go to the Ford plant, you'd watch the drill press, and that's such a great sound. And each one is another fender, you know. And it was just, I thought, God, those are impressive sounds, big sounds, and they're so regular and simple. I thought, those are sounds that even we could master. At first, we'd just have any old riff that was okay, and we'd go along and play it for a while, and I'd sing whatever came into my head, and I would change the song every month. And I would act it out and dance around, and I was taking my feeling and my dances from a combination of the things I felt when I was walking around on drugs, the things that I saw American Indians do, and also dances that I'd seen done in Chicago at the blues bars. You had rowdy elements in the audiences in Michigan, and also you had kind of resistant elements. And so I started mixing it up with the crowd, and if they wouldn't give me what I wanted, I would go out and take the show to them.